I'm going to kill this bastard, even if I have to use cheaty methods. I am going to hello everyone, Senpai here. Starting straight off with my stupid attempt of the day to kill this guy, the hero of, Fuck-a-you. That's his new name. He's the hero of Fuck-a-you. And, there's a tainted sheep. Hi, tainted sheep. How are you? Wait, where are you? Hello? Okay, tainted sheep is invisible. Note to self, be careful. Invisible sheep are tainted. Hell crap. Invisible taint sheep. That does not sound good. Alright, we have our tainted little area, so let's get it through here. Leave me be, taint. Death? Nope, no death. Huh. Oop. And through here. And through the passage of Nigh Can't See Diddly Squat. Oop. This world has already been overcome with taint. Yeah. This spot hasn't, though. Huh, very nice. Are you still in here? Hello? I'm worried, because I feel like he's still going to be in here. Yes? No? Hello? I don't even have a quest book on me. Okay, let's drop. Get out of my inventory. Get out of my inventory, you pain in my ass. Okay, I'm fine. Ooh, whoa. Promethium chest plate. Neat. Come on. Come on, I know you're here. Come on. Out of here. Out of here. Shoot. Shoot. Ooh. Wait, I hear you. You wait until I open my inventory. You waited for that. You do not even lie. You waited. Get out of here. Die right now. Die right now. Holy crap. And there's still more. I can hear them. Yep, I'm not going to let any more of you fuckers spawn. Come on, die. There we go. There's another one over there, too. Great. Come on. Come on. Come on, you bastard. Come on. Come on. Taint swarms are the biggest pain in the ass to kill, other than this hero douchebag. Oh, God. Oh, come on! The fuck out of my inventory! Ow. You can't get me! How do you feel about that, huh? Buddy? Huh? Huh? Ooh, a Damascus steel sword. Neat. Yeah, I could use this for killing them. Or I could use that. Wait, I have flux flute. Oh, great. I'm gonna be puking up taint. Delish. Who wants a taint sundae? No, not Sunday. Ugh. Ignore me, I can't talk. I just grabbed something, didn't I? Taint tendril. Okay. I put my pickaxe away. Why haven't I just been doing this entire time? Yeah. This is so much faster. Look at that. Ah, God, I have flux flu again. Okay, is that all? Besides for the spore stock. There we go. Anything? Anything? I've secured the middle. Oh my gosh, I did it! I secured it! It's safe! Wait, wait, no, it's not. F- Fuck you. Yeah. Can't get me now, douche. Oh god. Come at me, bitch. And you're dead. Ha. Can't kill you when you're dead. Can you? Now it's going to try to do that. I really should keep my mouth shut. Alright. City center. You know, I imagined more. I'm gonna be honest. At least a teleporter? Let's see, there's a question mark over here. Please be a teleporter. Nope. Oh, jeez. Oh. Just go ahead and get rid of you. Ow. Okay, if you could stop doing that. Oh. I can eat. I can finally do that. Okay, so there's a question mark over there, and I'm wondering if that could be a teleporter. I'm not going to climb on you. Come on. There we go. I think? Why is that taint on? I don't know. Oh, no. You're not that. Great. Yep, you die easily. There we go. Oh, shit. No. You can go down there, sir. And fuck right with it. I have that. But yeah, where is my teleport? I want my damn teleport. Ouch. What? I don't even see. Fuck them. Jeez. Ah, jeez. Yeah. Well, that's my one attempt for today. I don't want to do another one. Maybe at the end. No, maybe? No. So let's get out of here and... Well, yeah, I don't want to make you guys wait that. I'll be back when I'm on land. Now, before the episode, I did do my usual Thaumcraft stuff, so I put it in this little bookshelf right here. I did 3 of them. Don't direct click with that. I did the Helmet of Revealing. Pretty simple. Not too much. This is why I can't use Photoshop. We got the Spellbinding Cloth. Hey, look, lots of void. The Sad Palm Top of Thaumaturge. Oh, you poor thing. And the Dawn Machine. The End of Taint. My God. This. Very, very big. Let's hope it's worth it. Ready? I put my book away too. No. This one. Alchemy. Offering of Dawn. Clean all the places. You have done it. You have created the most effective and the most needlessly complex taint-killing machine that will likely ever exist. It is a fusion of Homeworld's technical mastery and the recently discovered alien magic technology. You will call it the Dawn Machine. You begin by taking the Dawn Totem and augmentation with wires, gears, and processors. Infusing it with Essentia is a key part to this process. This grants you the call to the Dawn Machine. The Cyber Totem? Really? Oh my god. That looks awesome. To create the Dawn Machine, take the Cyber Totem and place it between 2 silvered logs. Each 3 blocks high, as shown in the following picture. Right-click the totem with the wand, charge with Ordo to finish the construction. At its most basic, the Dawn Machine functions like a Totem of Dawn, with a slightly longer range that acts slightly more reliable. It also acts as a chunk loader. Oh, I love you so much. To help with the cleanup process. However, the machine can be upgraded by providing it with Essentia. There are 10 different ports to the Dawn Machine, each type a different type of Essentia. Each type of Essentia will upgrade the machine a different way. If given Sono, location, Essentia, any tainted villagers, chickens, cows, pigs, and creepers in the area, cleansed by the Dawn Totem, will be healed of their infection. If given air, the Dawn Machine's cleansing area will increase to 128 squares from 64. Oh, it will still load all the affected chunks. Keep in mind, this means the chance of any given square being cleansed will be lower. If given Ignis Essentia, the Dawn Machine will burn away tainted blocks as it cleans, purifying dirt, liquefying crusted taint, and eradicating fibers, as though a purity focus was used in the area. This ensures the area stays clean and prevents imminent reinfection. If given Vacuous Essentia in addition to Ignis, then the goo created by destroyed crusted taint will be vacuumed up. Because flux goo can also cause taint, this can also help prevent an area from becoming reinfected. If also given Arbor Essentia in addition to Vacuous and Ignis, then a sapling will be planted anywhere there used to be a tree. The Dawn Machine can tell where a tree used to be by detecting crusted taint blocks stacked on top of each other. Oh, that's nice. If given Aurum, tainted Auronotes in the area will be cured of their taint. Oh, that's kind of sad, though. If given Arbra, grass will be immediately replanted anywhere dirt is exposed to direct sunlight. If given Ordo, the Dawn Machine will cleanse consecutive squares instead of random squares. This makes it less likely that there will be a missing spot. If given Cognito, the Dawn Machine will be smart enough to skip over any previously cured land if the spot it attempts to clean is already clean. It will immediately pick a new spot to clean instead. Oh my gosh. Let me give it a... If given Mechanus, the Dawn Machine will work 3 times as quickly, activating 5 times per second. Jeez, there's a lot of reading. The amount of essentia this machine consumes is astounding. There is a way to lessen it, though, however, providing RF to the Dawn Machine. Though the plug directly under the totem's head has the amount of essentia the machine requires, 2 jars of each essentia augmented with RF should, in most cases, be enough to completely terraform a 128 by 128 block back to a pristine natural state in under an hour, during which time you are completely free to be elsewhere. Now that you have the research to do this, this final task will come in order of providing the needed essentia. The setup is hard to move, but there is at least one way you know will work. Archimedes ships, the whole Dawn Machine setup, including water jars, essentia tubing, and energy cells, but not flux ducts, can be placed on a flying ship and carried away. The Dawn Machine or its tubing needs to be deactivated in transit and may need to be sorted upon arrival. To prevent this from happening, try to always park facing the same direction you made the ship to begin with. To keep it from consuming essentia when not in use, a redstone current may be applied to the center block to deactivate it. Oh, God. Oh. Let me have a breather after that. Holy crap. That was a lot of reading. I haven't read that much since high school. Jeez. Well, I actually have read one that since high school. I read a lot of books, but out loud, I mean. Out loud. I'm not used to reading out loud whatsoever. So, while I'm off camera real quick and actually getting a breath, I'm going to go ahead and do that last research. I want that. I don't know why. I do not know how. I am just going to get it, and I'm going to be happy. I have squid. Be right back, everybody. Okay, I've gone ahead and taken a breath, and look at this weird little thing we got here. And it was actually a lot easier than the previous research, so I don't know if it's going to be worth it. So let's grab it. I hope you... Wait, did you see that? Okay. Pause if you want. Offering of Dawn. What do you do? Okay, this is a lot smaller. The Dawn Machine is an amazing piece of machinery, but it's hard to move for this reason. You have invented the Dawn Offering, a piece of obsidian infused with teleportation magic that can call the Dawn Machine to its location to use it. Right-click the Centuria Dawn Machine with a wand, then place the Dawn Offering block in the world. Right-click the Dawn Offering with the same wand to teleport the Dawn Machine. For convenience, all connected jars to being RF cells in a 5x5 area centered at the Dawn Machine will be teleported as well. This is nice. The Dawn Offering is destroyed in the process. It cannot be reused. Aww. At least it's easy to make. Just a diamond nugget and obsidian. It is convenient. It's just... It's just not Dawn Machine level of amazing. Oh, God. Okay. That was strange. But anyway, that's something I've been forgetting to do for like five episodes. It's this side. I always forget. I do not know why. We go down. Hello, taint. We go down. Stop giving off weird particles. Just a sec. Yeah, if you could make this not a thing, that'd be great. Thank you, darling. You're wonderful. Oh, wait. Okay, we didn't. Ooh, wait. Ooh. Oh, yeah, that's in the tree. And that's the one behind the tree. We have our tainted villager. Hello, tainted villager. We also have these. Despair shard. We have the taint shard. We have the nether shard, which we actually need for Ikorium. Unless they change that as well. We have the entropy shard. And we have the bucket of blood. Heck yes. Aww. That's sad. I wanted to scan a bucket of blood. Anything else here we can scan while we're here? No. No. Item frame. Yep, alright. What I actually came over here for is this. If we grab out our quest book. That's later. We'll get to that in a minute. And we go into the Paranormalist. Hello! There you go. Are you happy now? Will you stop being a butt? Whoa! Holy crap. That's a lot more than there was. Sleeping venom. Neat. I don't even have potatoes though. Huh. We have the supreme infiltration, the traveling trunk. I hide in a chest, then we get the chest to walk around the ground while nobody's looking. Really? Man, I bet Solid Snake wishes he had one of these. I bet Solid Snake does. 3 tiny potatoes, a strokolum, and a French gourd. You can use a big enough distraction that Bryson leaves the hyperscan room. But forgets to lock the door behind him. And you know what would distract his anabologist the most? Unexplained artificial life doing distracting things like playing a French horn. And tiny potato. Wait. Artificial life playing a French horn? Then why do you need tiny potato? I don't even know. Who needs doors? I hear you can make something called a portable hole. That would make it really easy to sneak into the scanning room. Locked doors are no match for the power of a thaumaturge. They really aren't. Anything else? Nope, nothing new? Okay, good. Now stop giving me new stuff, it's actually really difficult. Is that a bullshit? Anything? I need more. That would require me to go back into the hellhole. But yeah, let's make the real alchemy set and then I want to attempt the freaking city again. I know I said I wasn't doing... Well, actually I said I was, but and wasn't at the same time, but meh. I'm me. I don't have to listen to myself. Why would I? Oh, so posh. No. I would never listen to myself. Who would listen to that guy? I mean, he is that guy. Come on. No, nobody? Nobody will listen to me? Good. Never do. It's a bad idea. I come up with way too many bad ideas. Like 20. A day. Okay, fine, every hour, but still, come on. Throw me a bone here. I'm trying not to look too bad. Bite him alpha. What did I say I was going to do? Oh yeah, I'm going to make the alchemical chemistry set. And for that, you know what we need, right? We need obby. Obsidian. I need a bucket. That's what I need. No bucket. There's a bucket. Why can you not work? Can I turn you back? Blaze lamp into obsidian. Huh. Neat. I wish you could turn that back. That'd be convenient. But no, too convenient for us. Then let's grab water, and let's go. We're going to use our sexy Atlas pickaxe. And I hope I don't get lost. I think it's this way. Go this way. Go down. Right through here. Right through here. Shut up, cricket thingies. Then we go this way. This way. Up. My god, this is a labyrinth. All of it's my own making except for this cave right here. So I can't really blame generation for this. Oh yeah, that's right. I can't. Wrong one. This one. Why, thank you. And only one piece. Fuck are you two. Fuck are you two. And we continue down on our journey. Lava. Ow. Of course, right as I get to the lava. Thank you. And it looks like there's not anything under it either. So let's grab our obsidian. Oh, jeez. I was pretending to be asleep there. I even closed my eyes. Brain, why do you let me do this? I don't give a damn that it's fun. Okay, it was fun. Okay, I will admit, it was fun, but still. Not nice. It's not nice, me. If you could not, that'd be fantastic. And yeah, I know we only need two, but I also want an enchantment table. Why an enchantment table? Because I want an enchantment table. You know, enchanting things is always nice. Oh no, I'm not going to be well fed. I need one more. Probably two just to be a butthead. No, one more. I don't want my viewers to sit through this. Oh my gosh. Mining obsidian is dreadfully boring. And, well, at least the run back is going to be entertaining as I see here dying. Cause taint. Why am I dying? Essentially, cause taint is the answer to everything. Except for that hero. The hero is the cause of actually half my deaths in this entire Let's Play. So I can actually attribute a lot to him. He is a dick waffle. That is all I have to say about that guy. He is a dick waffle. My gosh. Not even cheeky, he's just a dick. 100% pure unadulterated dick. There we go. And with this, we should be able to craft. I have two. I don't want to grab it out of the chest. Thank you. We go back up. We see our glass that is still somehow alive, even though there's tons of tainted death. And we go into here. We go into the supplier. We yoink a blaze rod. Thank you. And I need a crafting table. Three cobble. And my blaze rod. There's the brewing stand. We put the two obsidian. Where's my blood orb? There's my blood orb, thank you. We grab the alchemical and a thingy kabutlutterkredurk. We go in here. We go down to our dark one. Real oh, that gave nothing. Ancient artificial sword. I see you have a need for diamond swords, but your pathetic government has too much sway over you. Very well, I shall assist you in overcoming this apparently binding executive mandate. Place two diamonds and a stick in my alchemy set. Really? Wow. Getting around the law. In a weird way. Where is a diamond? There we go. So, okay. And a stick. Well, like this. Blood orb. You know what? I just have to look up the friggin' recipe. Diamond sword. Oh, I need... Oh, do I also need... I need a stone sword blade, too? Eh, well, I guess it isn't exactly difficult, but... I need more cobble. Damn it. I thought I got away with just enough cobble, but no. It has to say, no, we secretly have one more that you need to grab. And sword blade. Oh, give me my nitro, thank you. And let's go ahead and put that, because it's safe, I'm going to put it right next to our chickens. Thank you. And let's go ahead and put on our sword blade. Two diamonds. Do they really have to be in that exact order? I need 2,000... Oh. Oh, delicious. Delicious nutrient bars of the day.
Yeah.
Oh. They have not once been mean to me this entire game. They have done nothing but give me secrets. Stick, diamond, stone sword blade. Diamond, stone sword blade, stick. Yeah. We just need our, I need to actually be able to check how much I have, because... Honestly... Not knowing how much life you have, and how quickly you could die, is kind of bad. You know? Nothing. Itch. No, chicken. Chikun, move. Chikun. Shoot. Okay. There we go. That's all I was trying to do. Item collector. Free freaking stuff. Jeez. That Chikun had something about dying. And I tried to be nice, but he ran right in front of me again. Alright. Gotta be careful. No, still not? What the balls? Block amount of diamonds always nice. Sigil of compression. I hate waiting games, don't you guys? Wait, Man of Steel is super diamond level? I could have gotten Man of Steel. Do you know how easy it is to get Man of Steel? You can throw a block of iron into a little bit of mana and boom, you got it. But apparently, I did not know about that, so... Shitty pants. Can I yet? Nope. Jeez. You know what I might have to do? Where's my sacrificial knife? The one that I do just a prick, and it's done. No? No? Get out of my inventory. Now get down there out of my inventory. Yes, I know I'm being a little anal, but screw it. But. Screw it. No. Bad senpai. Bad. That is not what you're supposed to say to your kohai. Ooh, new research. I'll gladly take new research. Where did my vishroom... Yeah, there it is. And last thing, I'm going to... Go ahead, there we go. There we go. If you would. No? No. Well, you can make a shimmer leaf that way, that's nice. But yeah, I need a magician's master, archmage, transcendent, eldritch, so I need a magician's. Ah, shit. Well, I guess there's never any time better to show you the grinding needed to make a blood altar overpowered. I'll be back. And we're back at the Obsidian place. The Obsidian Tower of Potatoes and Death. Now, as you see, this is a Tier 1 altar. This little ring around it means it's a Tier 2. This ring, when completed, will be the Tier 3, which is needed to make the next blood orb. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we only need 8, which is nice, but to make each one, you need to put a stone in here, and then you wait until it's taken in a 1,000 essence, and it changes into that, a blank slate. For each of these little stone, you need 2 of those. So we wait for this, we take it, we go over to our crafting table. You know what? I don't like crafting tables. I just don't. I like crafting stations. Thank you. So to make it, we need to do this, and we need to do this, and then we grab our... I left my freaking orb in the thingy. Wow. But yeah, as you can see in... Where is it? Right there. Blood rune. You see 6 stone... 2 blank slates and a blood orb. But yeah, this is my issue with Bloodcraft, is how long it takes to get these things. Otherwise, I love Blood Magic. Blood Magic is a fantastic mod. It really is. And it doesn't do what people think that, you know, Satanists do. They don't actually say that it's involved in Satan in any way, which it really isn't. Being Satanist is actually just not that bad. You know, people can be great and be Satanists. And he kind of kept this mod away from that because he knew that people would try to draw conclusions in that. So that's what I'm trying to say, is that he was... Where the hell is my blood orb? It's in the thingy. Thank you, me, is that he's actually an amazing guy, and I am very proud of him. Obsidian Tower, there we go. Also, I say words weird, don't judge me. I always have to do that, I'm sorry. So now that we have our blood orb, we get back down here, we go down here, we continue going down. Go down and down and down, and my god, this is steep. And we threw this in here, and we could finally get 1. That was 1 blood orb. You know, it might not have seemed bad, but I already had blood in there. Or else it actually would have taken a bit longer. So we put our blood rune, now we need, you know, we still have all of the rest of them. And each blood thing is 1762, 1980, which is amazing because it comes with runes. It comes with these runes of sacrifice. Ooh. Scan? No. Scan? No. Dang you. And eat a delicious bar of yum. But yeah, each little prick of your finger is not that much. And it takes a ton of stone, too. See? And that's going to be enough. We're going to be able to make 2 more. So I'm just going to make this on camera just because I can. And, you know, I'll just sit here and talk to you guys in the meantime. Yep. There you go. But yeah, so how's everyone doing? You doing good in the comments down below? Anything new going on? The land of lollipops and potatoes? Seriously, grab that. Thank you. No? Nothing new? I am dying. Owie. See, it even says so in the corner of the screen. I am dying. I am very dying. Very, very sad pain. Owie, it hurts so bad. And we've completed our 3 that we made total. It took that long to make 2. 3. 3. Sorry, like I said, my brain no work. My brain no function correctly. That's good. We're missing one, and we're missing four. We're just missing five. Then we go to work on the next layer, and then the next layer. And then we need to get these panes in my ass. The netherrack is actually supposed to be large bloodstone brick. You know, it's not bad. You need to infuse a stone, and then we need the... I almost just walked into that lava. And then we need, on each of these corners right here... Yeah, I know. We need... And I hope you don't feel too bad about this. We need beacons. Four of them. Not bad. It's actually really easy to kill withers once you're going. So, yeah. Since we did blood magic and we appeased our Dark One. Oh, Dark One. Thank you very much. We will see you in the next video. Have a fantastic night, evening, whatever it is. You know? And just have a generally good time. Goodbye, everybody. I didn't even know I could get up there. Boing. Oh, now I can't. I'm never going to be able to get up there again, am I? No? No. This is why I don't parkour. Oh, I did it! Ah. See you in the next video, everybody. Goodbye!